Today on the show, we're discussing a new Red Dead Online mini update that's made its way into the game this week. It came in the form of a background update, and it brought a few new changes into the online world that I want to share with you all. This isn't a content update or anything like that, but every once in a while, we usually get these like smaller server-side updates where real game changes can be made to patch glitches or fix other in-game issues. So let's jump in. Definitely a shorter video here today. If you enjoyed this video at any point, or if you just find it helpful, let me know by dropping a like on this video. And if you want to stay up to date and in the loop with everything Red Dead Redemption 2 and Red Dead Online, consider hitting that subscribe button with your notifications turned on. Rockstar Games insider and enthusiast TezFun2 shared this initially, stating the following. So, Rockstar pushed out a new background update for Red Dead Online, fixing issues with races, rich pickings mission, etc., and he later followed up with, "Credit goes to Allocator. Another fix with yesterday's background update has the game clear up the map of NPCs upon any mission completion, possibly targeted at fixing sync issues." Now, we all know that there's issues with the Red Dead Online netcode and synchronization issues between players with the peer-to-peer servers, but I actually haven't really heard about what's wrong with the rich pickings mission or what's going on with clearing up the map with NPCs upon mission completion, nor do I recall reading any comments about these that supporters left me on my videos, but upon hearing this news, I was really hoping that we finally got fixes for the Carmela Montez legendary bounty and the Moonshiner story missions, where simply starting and completing these missions will result in the game removing lots of items from your account. And honestly, if left unchecked, you could be losing hundreds or even thousands of dollars without even knowing. Now, for those wondering what I'm talking about, the glitch specifically with the Carmela Montez legendary bounty has to do with certain items in your satchel, and this was initially reported by Austin BMX, and I tested this out on my own time a couple months ago, as well as on another time on one of my Twitch streams, and I found out that yes, this is true, and it's pretty crazy. Simply starting the Carmela Montez legendary bounty results in the player losing one gin, one rum, one potent miracle tonic, and one potent snake oil. Probably doesn't sound like a very big deal, but it does get worse than that. If you fail this mission and either replay it from the checkpoint or restart, it doesn't matter which, you lose two more of each of those items. So you already have a total of three lost gin, rum, potent snake oils, and miracle tonics just from one mission. And if you fail again, that's another two more, and the game just keeps on taking an additional two of those items away from you every time you fail this mission. If you were to then to just complete the legendary bounty or just quit and find a new session and log out of that legendary bounty, that results in another one of each that you're losing. So basically, it's guaranteed that just interacting with this mission in any capacity, that will cause you to lose two of each of these items. One when you start the mission and one when you end the mission. If you die and restart the mission, each time that happens, the game will be removing two more of each of those items from your satchel, and as a result, this means you'll be losing $35 worth of items just by starting and then subsequently completing this legendary bounty. But thankfully, with me testing this out today, this issue appears to be fixed, which is great news. Both the Carmela Montez bounty or the Moonshiner story missions are no longer affected by bugs that cause players to lose items simply by starting or completing the missions, but also dying in the middle of it and losing extra items when they try to retry from checkpoint or just completely restart. So now with that out of the way, what about other major problems that we've faced in the past? Let's talk black screen problems first. Rockstar fixed one of them and most of them in the past, but if you ever have sold your moonshine or tried to hunt legendary animals, you may have noticed that this still happens from time to time. The cause of this problem is because of the trader role and the fact that you're more than likely doing a delivery wagon sell mission for trader right before heading over to your moonshine shack to sell your moonshine, or you went to Harriet's to do a legendary animal mission. After Marcel speaks and the screen fades to black to load up the moonshine delivery mission, that's when you'll know if you got hit with the black screen or not. And when this happens, unfortunately, the only options you have are to close the game down, or if you're on PC, you can also try going to the resource monitor and suspend the RDR2.exe process for about 10 seconds or so until you disconnect. If you want to completely avoid this black screen problem and prevent it from ever happening again, that's all that's really needed is for you to get in the habit of switching lobbies after every trader sell before you do the moonshine sell, or you could just obviously sell your moonshine first. That works too. But when it comes to the naturalist role, you won't necessarily have a black screen, but you'll also have this like infinite loading screen where the mission doesn't load after you do the trader sell and then you try and do one of these legendary animal missions. In order to fix that, this issue doesn't seem to be fixed either, but what's necessary is you need to go to your item wheel and just listen for the sound of you pulling out dynamite, throw that at the ground and blow yourself up, and then the mission will start. I don't know if that happens on PS4 and Xbox, but it happens to me all the time on PC. and I don't have a fix for that. But unfortunately, with both of these black screen issues, these still seem to be in the game, and honestly, I'm not sure if Rockstar will ever fix these issues, considering they've survived multiple background updates, other small patches, and even full-on title updates, which introduce the most bug fixes when we get a DLC. Now, next is a bug with horses and your saddle and stirrups, where all of a sudden you notice your Nakadocha's saddle and your hooded stirrup combo seem to be broken. The stamina on your horse is draining very fast, like they usually are with a default saddle, and you aren't sure what happened. Did Rockstar nerf the Nakadocha's saddle and the hooded stirrup combo? No, in fact, that's just what happens if you feed your horse horse meal. That causes the saddle and stirrup combo to break, and basically, the stamina drain prevention effects won't actually work when this happens, and your horse's stamina will drain like no saddle is applied at all. Now, not only does this bug basically eliminate your stamina drain prevention talents, but it also does away with the regeneration buffs to stamina and health core drain rates too. So it's best you avoid horse meal entirely if you're a player who uses the Nakadocha's saddle and the hooded stirrup combo, and I'll be honest, I just got baited by this one. I just fed my leopard Appaloosa a horse meal while she had a silver Nakadocha's saddle equipped, and she appeared to be unaffected by this bug, and I was testing it out and I was like, wow, it's fixed, this is awesome. But then I wanted to make sure, so I tried stabling her and calling out another horse just to make sure the game registered that I fed the Appaloosa the horse meal. And then when I pulled that horse back out of the stable, I noticed that the glitch happened again and her stamina started to drain super fast despite the Nakadocha's saddle and hooded stirrups combo, giving my horse what it should be, which is an 85% decrease in the stamina drain rate. So unfortunately, this bug is still in the game, and that's quite unfortunate. And then also, inside the realm of horses is an issue that can affect any and every horse. This has been an issue for the longest time as well, with no fix ever added to the game up until this point, the issue of your horse being malnourished and the cores being completely drained. This was a problem when I was on PlayStation 4, and thankfully it was fixed when I switched to PC at launch, but many players still have to deal with this problem, and it's caused by owning a horse in the 5th stable stall if you only have the first 5 unlocked, or owning a horse in the 10th stable stall. Basically, it's just the last horse in your stable stalls is going to be the one that's glitched, and for some reason this bug only happens when all your other stable stalls are owned. Many players think it's something wrong with the actual horse, and that's not necessarily true. Feeding your horse to full health and stamina cores don't really make a difference, as the horse still hangs its head in pain. Fleeing your horse or stabling it briefly will cause its cores to drain again, and no matter how many times you feed it with food or horse meal or anything like that, it won't make any bit of difference. The horse is bugged because it's in that glitch stable stall. Now, if you discard that horse and you buy a new one, you'll also have wasted your money because you'll get the same glitchy results no matter what horse you buy. So it's best you just leave that stall untouched, because this glitch is still a thing for me on my PlayStation 4 account. And if there are any other issues that have appeared as symptoms to this background update, because usually there are, Rockstar always causes more problems when they fix something, or if you noticed any other changes, please let me know in the comments below so you can help out the community as well as myself and keep all of us informed. I just wanted to go over all the most major problems that have long existed in this game to see if maybe, just maybe, Rockstar fixed them, and in some cases they did, so that's great news. But with all of that said, we will wrap things up right here. Hopefully you all enjoyed the video today, and if you did, hopefully I earned your like on it. And of course, if you are new to my channel and want to stay up to date with the best Red Dead Online and Rockstar Games content, consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out on a single thing. We consistently talk about updates, news, information, tips, tricks, and even leaks, and we'll keep you guys updated here on the channel daily, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you want to follow me over on Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, those are the best places to get connected with me outside of YouTube, and you're more than welcome to ask me any questions on there. You can follow me at HazardousHDTV, and all of my social media links can be found in the description down below. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching, everyone. I hope you all have a fantastic day and a great rest of your weekend, and I will see you guys in the next Red Dead Online video. Adios, amigos.